But hold on one second.
How do you know this? How
hold
you
on one second.
Where is your evidence?
Right.
Where is your
okay.
Evidence?
Name me an Islamic organization that does as much as the Catholic Church in terms of charitable output.
So this is a nice story that you're producing at the park, but I sort of did some heckling because I sort of wanted to do some pushback against this.
So give me your evidence.
I don't believe that.
Give me your evidence. Evidence. When I was saying that the Catholic Church is the biggest charitable giving organization, you were mocked it and you said I was wrong. Are you willing to take that back?
No.
And then you go into your own kind of rhetoric around Islam and an unorganized group of paedophile rings to justify an organized biggest religion with masses of power throughout the centuries hiding that paedophilia.
So, bro, you came up with some rubbish that the church doesn't do a lot to help the poor. Where are you getting that information from?
You know, when they spread all that nonsense. You know, they just speak all nonsense, don't they, the church?
Sorry. No, we're talking about factual stuff,
sure.
Right? So we're not talking about bullshit, quips, or platitudes. We're talking about charitable output. Going to help the poor.
What have we changed the doing, framework?
No,
changed
no, no.
The framework?
No, one second.
Like,
one second.
Yeah,
I was talking about the charity that the church does to the poor,
yeah.
And I said that we, Christians, do more than any other group.
No, well, what, I'm
right,
not
going
so, with that
evidence, please. Evidence.
Evidence.
Evidence,
so,
yeah.
So this is a great evidence generator, isn't it?
Yeah. Go on, let's go to evidence.
We go with largest charity.
Yeah.
Is it? So
the Catholic Church. Go on.
You don't need this.
Go on. Pull it up. What have we got? Largest charity.
Just trying to spell it.
Largest charitable output.
Apparently it's the Nova Nordisk Foundation. Oh, Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation.
Oh, by
oh, that's wealth. We're doing
right.
It by wealth.
So by wealth. Now,
yeah.
let's compare the work of Bill and Melinda Gates.
Yeah, let's do it.
Right? They focus on medical, making medical treatments available to the poorest.
They do.
And I laud them for it.
Good, me too.
Not criticizing them for it.
Yeah.
But every parish church of the Catholic Church in every diocese will be doing things to help the poor.
Didn't that Catholic Church
do some terrible
stuff?
One second.
What am I talking
if
about?
If you go.
Yeah, I know, but.
If
no,
you
I'm
go.
Generally.
No, bro, right. We're just talking facts. I'm just asking
okay.
you to deal in facts,
let's do it.
Not platitudes,
okay.
Not nonsense.
Let's do it.
Right? Because that's what you're dealing with right now.
No, I pulled out the.
One second.
Generator.
One second.
Evidence,
yeah, let's look at that. Let's look at that.
Okay.
I am telling you that every parish church of the Catholic Church in the entire world does output that is charitable in its communities.
Fair enough.
How big is that?
So look, all we got to do, we say there's loads of nodes.
How big is that?
There's loads of nodes spread around different countries and they all do a certain amount for their community.
Brilliant.
So then we can sum up that total and be like, oh, that's at that level. Yeah, but I could sort of produce some other things that do some other great work.
What other organisation can you compare to the Catholic Church in terms of its reach?
In terms of its reach? Well, the Bill Gates and Melinda Foundation, that's quite well
its
known.
Its scope is narrow.
No, it's infected.
Its scope is purely medicinal.
It's affected, I almost said infected. Affecting millions of people.
I'm not knocking them. But I'm just pointing out it's not as big as the Catholic Church.
Well, I just pulled out the thing. Apparently it's second largest.
The Bill and the Melinda Gates Foundation don't do charity work in London. Sorry, one second. Do the bill. Where's the branch that I can go to get my medicines in London?
No, they don't do that.
Oh, but the Catholic Church does.
Yeah. Well, they do some. They don't give you medicine, do they?
Oh, actually, they do. Actually,
really?
Yes, they do. Actually, there are Catholic hospitals in London.
Mm.
So you're wrong again.
Oh, no, wrong once.
No.
Not even
you've been.
Not even
you've
wrong.
Been, you've been wrong.
Not even
so,
wrong.
So
even
when
wrong,
we
just shown something.
So when we
not
look at
wrong, just shown something.
So when we look
just
at. So when we look at Catholic schools. Catholic hospitals, the food bank, the food banks
maybe,
established in churches. Now, bearing in mind,
maybe,
bro.
Maybe Islamic culture then would have the same sort of thing.
Hold on.
They've got a principle of like.
Let's look at that.
We can sort of pit religions against
each
other.
Yeah, we can pit religions against one another.
Yeah.
We can pit religions against one another. In terms of your statement, I said
what
that the Catholic Church, I said that the Catholic Church was the biggest organization doing charitable work.
Yeah.
No, you said that was rubbish.
No, you said it was the biggest charity.
It is.
the biggest charity.
All right, maybe I need to rephrase this ever so slightly.
Yeah.
We're
totally stuck in the weeds in this debate.
No, we're really not, because I've got facts and you've got platitudes.
So if we like sort of get away from the actual conflict and we look at it, it looks like you're saying the Catholic Church is the strongest beacon of light within the communities that are doing good work. That's what you're saying.
No, what I said was that you were mocking from the sidelines.
I was.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah.
Was that the Catholic Church does more charitable work than any other single organisation on earth, and that is a fact. But hold on one second.
How do you know this?
Hold on one second.
Where is your evidence?
Name me an Islamic organisation that does as much as the Catholic Church in terms of charitable output.
That's not evidence.
There are entire monastic orders dedicated to good works and charitable output. Like the White Fathers that work in Africa. Do you know what they do?
No idea.
No. What about the Sisters of Mercy? Do you know what they do?
No, exactly.
You don't know nothing.
But I asked you to produce some evidence, and you asked me.
I've just given you two organizations.
Yeah. No, you didn't.
Two organizations within the Catholic Church that do charitable work right across Africa, helping the poorest of the poor. Do you know what Opus Dei do?
No idea.
No, of course you don't. Because you don't know anything, you've just got platitudes.
Opus Dei.
Opus Dei. Opus Dei as part of their Opus Dei. Opus Dei. Opus Dei. Opus Dei. Opus Dei. Are you willing to admit that you were wrong in what you said?
What did I say?
When I was saying that the Catholic Church is the biggest charitable giving organization, you were mocked it and you said I was wrong. Are you willing to take that back?
No.
Right.
No.
Then produce your evidence to show me that I'm wrong.
Okay, so we're saying biggest. So what do we want to know? Do we want to know
Here's it. Biggest in scope.
In scope?
Biggest in output.
Let's just get rid of the scope one.
Why? Because it's a definition that doesn't work for you.
No, because it's retardedly subjective.
No, it isn't. It's a very objective definition.
My scope is to
We're comparing a charity that only works in part in Africa on a charity that works in every part of the world, then scope isn't an objective measurement, isn't it?
It depends.
Isn't it?
We can change the definition of the word scope to encompass something that
I'm talking about geographical scope.
You should talk about it like population influence.
In terms of population influence, yeah, I'll still back the Catholic Church against any organisation you put up against it.
That guy agrees with that.
And this, by the way, is before I add on to the Catholic Church, all the work of the Orthodox Church, all the work of the Anglican Church. Oh, he's not even listening. All the work of the Salvation Army, all the work of the Church of England, all the work of the Baptist Church, all the work of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, all the work, you know, my list goes on. All the work of the evangelical funds, all the work of the evangelical churches. So I add all of these things.
I don't know what this is. This is just a private website. That can be
did you even listen to what I just said?
Yeah, you listed a load of institutions that you're going to add on to the charity of the Catholic Church.
Brilliant.
And then you're going to make a second point.
Yeah, and so the point is, that all of these things is my community. We Christians are the ones leading in charitable work everywhere.
So this is a nice story that you're producing at the park. But I sort of did some heckling because I sort of wanted to do some pushback against this.
So give me your evidence.
I don't believe that.
Give me your evidence. Evidence. I'll read it if he doesn't. What's the source? Inquirer.net, which he calls bullshit because it's about to contradict him. But the Catholic Church is more than a spiritual institution, apparently using the strategy of non-coercive power, Deus Vult, the geopolitics of the Catholic Church 2010. The church runs 5,500 hospitals, 18,000 clinics, 16,000 homes for the elderly and those with special needs, with 65% of them located in underdeveloped and developing countries.
Let's have a look at their numbers again. What is it? Of Catholic Church. The church runs 5,500 hospitals, 18,000
clinics, 16,000 homes for the elderly.
Located in undeveloped and developing countries. Lovely.
Yeah. Give me, and believe me, that's not even a complete list of all the things that the Catholic Church does. It's not even a roundup. That's a very small list of all the things. What about all the food banks in all the parishes? Mm. What about the fact of all the non-recognized charitable works that we Christians do? Because every Catholic who gives to Saint, is it Saint, who,
so you're saying that Saint
Peter's Pence or Saint Simon's Pence? Saint Peter's Pence, which is a collection that's done regularly for the poor and the underprivileged in the parish. The sort of the charitable work.
What's your point,
my point is, in terms of charitable output, that all counts for the Catholic Church.
That's all for the Catholic Church's
side. Every Catholic who acts because of their faith charitably counts towards the charitable output of the Catholic Church.
It does, and we can minus all those that have tried to get rid of their religion and their like affiliation with all of this nonsense, and sort of just act goodly on their own behalf.
They're not part of the Catholic Church, we do minus those.
So
yeah, absolutely.
Other charities that we could look at to see how large they are.
Yeah, so give me one.
And also, we could total all of them individuals that are not acting.
Give
on the
me
side
one.
Of,
give me a single institution as big as the Catholic Church involved in charitable work.
That's not the framework that we were setting up there. We were framing.
No. I made a claim about the Catholic Church that you mocked, which means that the definement of the charitable cause is the one that I set up, because I made about the Catholic Church, which means we're using the Catholic Church as the model. So you've got to come up with an institution that is bigger than the Catholic Church, that does more charitable work than the Catholic Church, that influences more people than the Catholic Church towards charity. Which is it?
You haven't compared the Catholic Church to anything else. What about all the Muslims and their 10%?
10% Muslims, the guy says. I tried that one.
It's actually 2.5%, it's not 10%. Christians give 10%. Christians give 10%, bro. Muslims give 2.5%.
Is that my homework, anyway? Is that my homework to check it?
Hold on. Yeah. You mocked my claim about the Catholic Church.
I did.
Right, yeah. So now you have to bring forward an organisation that is as big as the Catholic Church.
No, two things can actually happen.
Go on, bring what's the organisation?
We can either, not what's the organisation. We can look at the Catholic Church and get a number or a measurement for its influence and effect.
You can't, it's too big.
That's not a genuine response.
No one has been able to do the study you're asking it to do.
This is why, when I first saw you, you're a crusader, because you are blindly following one light.
I am proud to say I am a crusader.
Nothing ever went wrong with crusaders, did they? They always did honourable good
work. Are you trying to change the subject?
No, I'm not. You led me down.
He is trying to change the subject, isn't he?
He led me down a path.
No, you made a claim and he just refuted it. So either retract it.
I made a claim.
Just have the decency to retract.
No,
just have the decency to retract what you said.
No.
Or prove that I'm wrong. He said, when I said that the Catholic Church is the biggest organisation involved in charitable output, he laughed at that, said I was talking rubbish. So now he has to produce an organisation that's bigger that's doing the same.
Don't you have to give the second in line for that charitable work? You know, you're saying it's biggest, you've given numbers, you haven't given dollar amounts. Don't you have to compare that to the second biggest in order to say it's the biggest?
No, we already found that by dollars, by wealthiest charity, we've already found that Bill Gates and Melinda Gates Foundation is second.
But the comparison is a flawed one, because he mocked a claim about the Catholic Church. So he has to find an organization that has the same scope and breadth and width and depth as the Catholic Church. Bearing in mind that the Catholic Church, in terms of its charitable work, does things like medical care, social care, prison chaplaincy work, social reform, criminal reform. It also supports the charities in terms of the production and preservation of art, culture. It sponsors music. This is the full scope of the Catholic Church. It is an amazing organization. And this is before, bro, I pull in all of the other Christians who are also involved in charitable work and good deeds. The Salvation Army. Let's just deal with this brother's point.
Go on, go. Follow him.
Let's just take the pressure off this guy, because he's obviously out of bullets. Let's just deal with this guy. He claimed falsely. Yeah, but you just heckled me from us. So give me your evidence.
I've already pulled out evidence to do with one.
And here's. And
which
did you not listen? I refuted your evidence.
Keep just marching on. I'm trying to reflect.
Let's refute the evidence. Christians. Let's review. I can shout louder than you.
No, this is the battle.
I really can shout louder than you.
So let's do a conversation.
No, I'm going to try and hold the conversation. No, let's have a conversation.
Look at Bill Gates, Melinda Gates. They spend billions.
Should I shout, guys, or should I just talk?
All sorts of people. Right. They spend it all over the place on vaccines. They try and raise people out of poverty. They try and enlighten people. This influences the whole world.
Can I get charity work? Can I get charity from the Bill Gates Foundation in London? No. Can I get charity from the Catholic Church in London? Yes.
Their scope is different. They've got billions of people that they're trying to focus on.
Their scope is narrow. By the way, I lord. Why are you frightened?
Sorry?
There we go. So in terms of in terms of the scope, I'm going to deal with your evidence.
This is why I can't make a point, because you don't let me make a point.
You did make a point. You mentioned the Bill Gates Foundation. This is the evidence.
Yeah.
So I'm going to refute the evidence. The way that I refute the claim and the evidence that's presented is because the evidence that is presented doesn't match the criteria. The criteria was the Catholic Church, because that was the claim that I made.
Catholic Church is not a criteria.
Okay,
by criteria,
I'm going to talk to you guys.
By criteria,
you all heard me make a claim about the Catholic Church. He heckled that claim about the Catholic Church, which means that rightly, in the course of the argument, the criteria is the Catholic Church. So what he has to do is he has to find the evidence that is as broad in scope as the Catholic Church and is as broad in scope as the output of the Catholic Church. And notice he doesn't want to deal with the evidence. So I'm going to deal with your point now.
Before you do.
So you claimed... Let me deal with your first point.
We'll do a comeback.
Go on, make your point and then I'll deal with both of them.
I'm not making an argument or a point. I was clarifying the issues. To be honest, from my observer point of view, I don't actually know what you're trying to... Like, if you win, what does that mean?
Right, so I'm going to deal with both points. I'll deal with your latter point first, and then I'll deal with your earlier point. So don't touch the camera, bro. It's not your camera. So in terms of
what's going to happen if I do?
Well, I'm going to take your hand off it. That's what I'm going to do. Yeah, that's what. If you touch the camera, I'm going to take your hand off because it's not your property. It's not your property. Is it your property? No, it's not your property.
It's not my property, but
no, it's not your property. Trust me, I've got JC's permission to touch his camera, you don't.
No, but you haven't got permission to touch me.
Well, if you touch someone else's property, I do have permission because I'm protecting someone else's property.
You're a policeman.
It's JC. Go and ask JC if I can touch his camera.
I bet JC. Let's come back.
I'm gonna come back. Go and ask him.
I will.
Go and ask him.
I will.
Right. So let's deal with his point.
Yes.
So his point was made. He's saying that the brother was asking, what's the point of this discussion?
Yes.
Here's the point of this discussion. Amongst critics of Christianity, there are a load of misconceptions, outright lies and myths that are spoken about Christians.
When Christians challenge
those people that perpetrate these lies, these myths, these stereotypes, these prejudices, and we challenge them to prove what they are saying, this is the reaction that we get.
We say produce the evidence.
So what's at stake is simply this: an accurate view of the Christian community versus the lies and stereotypes that are common currency amongst the critics of the Christian community. Now to your first point, sir, which you mentioned about Islam, and you said. Compare Islam's 10% to Christianity's charitable output. And I corrected the bro and I said that Muslims don't give 10%, they give 2.5%. But secondly, Muslims don't give 2.5% in charity. It's a tax. It's an obligation. It's a redistributive tax. It isn't charity. Christians give out of a cheery and joyful heart. We, our 10% that we give is not an obligation. It is not an obligation. I'm going to finish my point and then he can talk. He just has to have patience. That's all he needs to do. So we Christians give out of a joyful and cheerful heart. We don't have to give 10%. Some Christians give more than 10%. And that is why the Christian community is punching well above his weight in charitable giving. Right, there you go, bro.
Now, let's look at some of the other criticisms that are levied against or given to Christian faith and the whole Bible, the whole organization that you're trying to say.
Are you retracting your first one?
Now that is a cheating in the argument.
No, it isn't.
You were the one that heckled me off camera. I challenged you and you said, and you've refused to retract it. Retract what you've said, that's all you need to do. And then we can talk about something else.
Are you talking about the size of the Catholic charity? So all of that time, we're still on that point. All of this time, we haven't gone anywhere.
You started it by heckling.
Millions of trees of thought. And he just brings me back to this one trunk.
You just retract what you said because you're wrong, bro.
You can even chop that trunk of that whole tree down. I showed you a bigger charity.
You showed me, but it wasn't bigger.
I'll say there
was it bigger?
Yes, it has.
How is it bigger than the Catholic Church?
More money.
Where?
More money.
In one criterion, and I dispute even that, to be honest.
You dispute that?
Yes.
In Google.
Yes, because the wealth of the Catholic Church is in its property and land. How much land and property does the Catholic Church own?
Oh, I think it's about 3 to 4 trillion, I'm not sure.
Right, so far bigger than Google, far bigger than Bill Gates.
This is what you're saying, yeah, because it's factual. Because a lot of the time, yeah, people like me and you, it's wrong to make assumptions, but we make assumptions about religion, we make assumptions about faith. In real terms, they're doing a lot as well.
I agree.
In real terms. Whatever way you want to look at it, they're doing a lot, man.
But this is not...
Whatever way.
And that's before.
They get a lot. No.
Go on, bro. Yeah.
They do.
Yeah, they do.
You've got to look at it holistically. And you think about the ethics and the way they see things. Yeah. So they're doing a lot. And we've been influenced a lot.
A little bit.
I agree with that as well.
Yeah? You agree with that?
Because this guy's trying to claim something else. My point that is, you can't just crusade for a single thing of positivity with the Catholic Church. It's going to have to always be a fluctuating criticism and balance.
No, that wasn't the point that you made, bro.
He's not screwing.
That's not the point that he made. The point that he made, bro, was that when I said that the Catholic Church was the biggest charitable organisation, he said that I was wrong.
You are wrong.
So we're dealing in facts.
You are wrong.
So we're dealing in facts.
You are wrong.
What? How am I wrong?
In my pocket.
How much money does the Catholic Church have locked up in land?
Sorry?
Your pocket.
Everyone recognises a fact that you refuse to recognise.
So you've changed it. You're saying the Catholic Church
has
so much money because they own land. That's what you're saying.
No, I pointed out that you were even wrong in that way.
They got all the church, you got all the building in Memphis. Yeah.
They should share it out if they got so much money, shouldn't they?
And that, bro, don't get me... Yeah, bro.
Do you really believe in like concentrated wealth?
Come on. No.
Bro.
I disagree with that. I mean, all land was effectively gotten by...
Blood.
By violence and blood. That's why travelling people, like myself, believe it's a fucking height of shit.
Yeah.
And we can basically plot up wherever the fuck we want.
Yeah. I suppose that's one way of living.
Yeah?
yeah.
And no, I don't live like that. I'm a settled man myself.
I imagine you are.
But all this land here, how do you think it was got?
Like you already said, by violence. You already said.
Exactly that. Yeah?
Yeah.
The biggest
history's
man of rock fucking...
No, with respect, but that statement's not true either.
You don't think history's covered in blood?
No, history is covered in blood.
Yeah.
But ultimately, there's lots of ways that land is exchanged. Why is it we can't... Why do we resort to simplistic characterisations?
Because we're at the park.
The reality is, lots of land was simply donated to the Catholic Church.
This is risk. Okay.
Don't get me wrong, I'm not saying the Catholic Church didn't conquer land as well. It certainly did. You know, look at the Teutonic Knights in Eastern Europe. But I'm not denying that the Catholic Church did conquer land. But what I'm saying is, it isn't the case that all the land that's owned by the Catholic Church was simply conquered. Lots of it was donated.
Yeah, I know. So this is good. We're going to go down a rabbit hole.
So why can't you just deal in facts, bro? Because on every statement that you've made, you're factually wrong.
Yeah, let's deal in facts. I asked the audience, what is the largest charity by wealth that
is not the scope that you were mocking earlier.
Government.
Here's the thing, guys. For those of you that came late, I made a statement about... Wait one second. I made a statement about the Catholic Church. I said that the Catholic Church was the biggest organisation involved in charitable work. And this brother, like this sister behind, just jumps in and says that I'm speaking rubbish. Which means that the model that we need to check ourselves against is the Catholic Church. We've got to find an organisation that is as big as the Catholic Church and that does charitable work. We've got to talk in facts.
So, Bob, two things. One thing, I asked JC about that. He said it was fine, so you're wrong.
Yeah. Yeah. Let me go and talk to JC. We'll go speak to JC.
He hasn't got authority over his own mind and own beliefs.
Go on. Jesus. I don't think you probably told him the full context, but anyway.
Violent Christians.
Wait, hold on, that's not the point of the topic that we were talking about.
I'm getting on to that.
When he retracts the comment that he made.
Okay.
The point that we're debating is about whether the Catholic Church is the biggest organisation involved in charity. And notice the critics are jumping from every topic that they can.
I was referring back to a point made earlier.
Oh, look, he's put you on camera. Go on, grab his camera now and move it. Go on.
We know you don't. He's...
Right, go on.
Okay, so the wealthiest foundations by endowment value is number one is the Novo Nordisk Foundation.
Yeah, I got that one.
Wait. Bill and Gates is next. Yeah. Stitching, Welcome Trust.
Yeah, we've done this.
No, okay, yeah, but...
Hello, everyone on YouTube. You should got to come down here.
Welcome Trust, then the Buddhist Foundation. Later down is the Church of England. But the bottom line is all of these, if you look at the starting date... The founded date for these foundations, 1989, 1994, 1982, 1930. So these are so big, and they've been doing it in the last 40, 50 years.
So now allow me to address that evidence.
Compared to the Catholic Church, which politically has effectively commandeered a lot of money, rather than act into their base.
Actually, you're utterly wrong.
No, it's okay.
The fact that you jump on an iPhone and accept that information as gospel is ridiculous.
Good point, mate.
Here's why I think that this brother is factually wrong. Because this conversation started by me making a specific claim that this brother mocked, and then this brother chirped in because he wanted to back him. Yeah. No, so that the model that we need to find is something that is as broad in scope as the Catholic Church. Broad in terms of its geography, broad in terms of its charitable concerns. And I would bet the Catholic Church against any one of those organisations that I suspect are narrower in their geographical and in their charitable output. In other words, they will be special interest groups like the Bill Gates and Melinda Foundation is a wonderful organisation doing brilliant work purely based upon making medicines available to the poorest. Fantastic. But that is not same in scope to the Catholic Church that covers a whole range of charitable causes far bigger in scope than the Bill Gates Foundation and far broader in terms of its global output. Because the foundation of Bill Gates, the biggest one on your list...
No, it's not. It's Novo Nordisk.
Okay, I mean, I don't genuinely know what Novo Nordisk does, but I'll bet you, I'm willing to make a bet that it's similar. My criticism of the Bill Gates Foundation as evidence is also true of the Novid one.
You don't have to labour it, but the point is, the difference between some of these organisations, I can't speak for them all, that the Catholic Church gives that charity, and the cost of it is either to pull people into the belief in hell and cause suffering, or a highly sanitised situation of all the paedophilia by priests.
Okay, so let me just deal with that. Okay, so I'm going to broaden the conversation now.
You're the boss.
Yep. Yep. So let me, sister, come forward. Come and join us. Okay, so in terms, let me just deal with his point, sister, and then you come back with your point, yeah? Let me just deal with this bro's point. So in terms of this idea of missionary work being connected to the idea of drawing people into the Catholic Church, I want to say, first and foremost, I got no problem with that. There's nothing wrong with that at all. But however, I would also point out that it is a false characterization that the Catholic Church has this idea that you either accept our charity and our faith or you can't have our charity. Because the Catholic Church, the Catholic Church will do its charity regardless. It'll do its charity regardless of whether you become a Catholic.
That's just how good it is.
It is good. It is good. It is good. Bringing in questions like paedophilia. Let's just deal with the criticism of paedophilia. It's absolutely true that the Catholic Church utterly failed on this question. Paedophile rings did manage to embed themselves in the Catholic Church because of the weaknesses of the institution. But those same problems exist in society. They exist in society. It is part of human nature, sadly. It is a sexuality. It is a sexuality. That's the only way you can explain its prevalence.
I wonder what kind of job attracts people with that sexuality, that propensity.
I'm sorry, but notice, if someone made the kind of generalizations against Muslims that the liberals here are making about Catholics, they would be called Islamophobic. But yet, when they deal in stereotypes that Catholic priests are all paedophiles, no one accuses them of being guilty of a thought crime. Which only demonstrates the hypocrisy of our liberal society that this man thinks that he can deal in that kind of prejudice.
No,
go on, push his camera away now. Push his camera away now.
You are making a straw man argument.
Bro,
you're
bro,
telling
bro,
me.
You stand away from the camera.
Yeah.
So there we go.
Typical Christian.
There we go. So the brother.
So the thing is, Bob.
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go.
Okay.
Look at that. Yeah. The thing is, Bob. It's a straw man. Nope.
You're dealing in a straw man. You're dealing in a straw man.
You've had your loud voice moment. I know you have a loud voice. It's brilliant.
Yeah, I can do a loud voice. I'm trying not to do the loud voice. I really am.
You're not doing very well. So anyway, if I say, I wonder what kind of jobs attract those people with that sexual proclivity, is not the same saying all Catholic priests are paedophiles. So it's a very, very clear straw man argument if you put that words into my mouth. Nice try, Bob.
So, hold on 1 second. Hold on 1 second. The fact of the matter is, oh, go on, battery.
The fact of the matter is,
I'm going to let him do his chat. So, this is why I have to raise my voice, because people can't contain themselves.
It is a free world,
which is why after a while, when people persistently interrupt, I have to raise my voice. But if I shout, people say, why do you shout? You know, again and again and again. This kind of slurring of the Catholic priesthood diminishes the great and the good work of many Catholic priests.
They shouldn't have done it.
It is they.
The people
who is he talking about? The whole priesthood? No.
No, I didn't say that.
They shouldn't have done it. The fact of the matter is, there are paedophiles in every part of our society. Paedophiles operate in schools. We've had paedophile rings of Muslim men abuse children in the north of England. Thousands of them systematically. That was ignored by the liberal state because the liberal state couldn't call a spade a spade.
But
when we point out that there were Muslim paedophile gangs raping children in the north of England, the Muslims call us Islamophobes. But that when a liberal secularist points out the failures of paedophilic rings in the Catholic Church, no one accuses him of a thought crime. So that is the hypocrisy that we're talking about. So, can we go back to talking? 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 Let's go back to talking. So my point to you is, because
if you want a truth, then you need to give me the first word.
Then we'll shout. Let me land on my point. I'm going to finish my point, then come back. So my point to you is, bro. There has definitely been a failure within the Catholic Church, but that does not mean that the Catholic Church is not the largest charitable organisation in the world, which is how this conversation started, remember?
So why the 3 points that I made is, one, the wealthiest, largest charitable organisations in the world are the ones I listed out earlier, and they are only about 30 or 40 years old. The point I was making, which you didn't address, was that the Catholic Church has been going for more than 1,700 years. So that's another issue, right?
I'll come back to that.
And then the second thing is, if I say you're absolute straw man argument, saying that I said all priests are ex or paedophiles, all this, all that, and then you go into your own kind of rhetoric around Islam and an unorganised group of paedophile rings to justify an organised biggest religion with masses of power throughout the centuries hiding that paedophilia. So don't straw man me on that, that's all.
Okay, so let me respond to those 2 points. Firstly, I did address your point, because the thing that you jumped into a conversation with a guy who's now run away, because he always does, is that we were talking, I made a claim about the charitable output of the Catholic Church. That heckler over there jumps in and he said, that's a load of rubbish. That's wrong. Are you listening?
No.
So what? Hold on. Wait 1 second. And so, the model that we're looking for is something comparable to the Catholic Church, which means we're using the Catholic Church as our model for the criterion, which means that whatever organization we compare to the Catholic Church has to be as broad in scope geographically, as broad in scope in its charitable output, as the organization you're comparing it against. None of the organizations that you have presented meet that criterion. The only measurement that's being used there is of their finances. Their finances may be bigger than the Catholic Church organizationally in terms of what money's in the bank, but that doesn't mean that they are as broad a scope or as broad in geographical outreach as the Catholic Church, which is why I refute your evidence. Secondly, you made the point about 1700 years versus the modernity of these charities you mentioned. That only actually strengthens my argument.
Why, Bob?
Because that means that now I can appeal to all the charitable work that the Catholic Church has done for 1700 years.
Right.
By what you have just said, which actually makes the evidence far stronger in my favour than in yours. And then you said, well, let's talk about the paedophilia.
You talked about that
for 1700 years the Catholic Church has been hiding this kind of sexual deviancy. That is a lie. The Catholic Church, around, I think it was the year 800, institutionalized the idea of celibacy amongst its priests. Any priest carrying out sexual conduct of any nature is defying the teaching of the Catholic Church. So you're wrong, full stop and absolutely outright. Yes, there has been in modern times a failure that the Catholic Church has owned up to, paid tens of millions of dollars for, rightly in compensation. Oh, why don't you just grab his camera?
Listen.
Yeah?
So,
where were you? So, JC, do you want to come this way?
Go.
JC!
Okay. A little
bad time, that's alright.
Alright, here we go, go.
Yeah. So you're simply wrong, bro.
No!
In everything that you're saying.
No, bro, you did not address what I said.
What did I miss?
Okay, what you missed was the second point that I made was that you made very clear straw man arguments by generalising my statement and then saying, oh, poor Christianity, what about Islamophobia? What about... That is the straw man issue is what I'm addressing. None of the Catholic Church yet. I'm asking about your tendency to do straw man arguments and not admit it. Look,
okay, so let's talk about whether it's a straw man.
No.
You just said your second point was about straw man arguments, so I'm going to address that.
Define, before you go on to rhetoric, let's define what straw man argument I'm accusing you of.
Go on then.
So I said, first, two things. I said, I wonder what kind of jobs attract paedophiles.
Yeah.
And you went on to say, oh, he's saying all priests are paedophiles. And then another time when I was talking about the church, it was again, you generalised it all and you talked about Islam, Islamophobia, Christophobia, and that is the straw man argument that I'm addressing.
Okay.
If you're happy to do that.
So here's the thing. That question that you asked wasn't just given in a vacuum. It was given in a context. And in the context of that conversation, you implied either accidentally or deliberately that the Catholic Church, the whole of the priesthood, was rife with paedophilia, was rife with the covering of paedophilia, and has been doing so for 1700 years. Those are the words that I have heard you say.
If you want to retract that impression, or correct it, feel free. You reacted to what I said before I said any of those other things.
And it's a trope, incidentally, that's common currency amongst the middle-class white English.
Bob, what you're saying is that what I'm implying or what I haven't said. If you want to know what I was meaning or saying, then you can ask for clarity.
So I'm asking you, clarify.
You can ask for clarify.
Clarify.
There is some high...
Oh, some?
Yeah.
Some?
Yeah.
Okay, much better. Got no problem with that. I'd agree with that. I'd agree with that. I agree with that completely. There are some. And they're wrong. But here's the thing. The Catholic Church institutions celibacy. Where does it permit paedophilia?
Well, here is not the thing. You're talking about paedophilia in the Catholic Church. I'm talking about your tendency to do straw man arguments.
Well, I'm not interested in debating me.
Right. Well, that's the problem. You'll never
learn.
I'm not interested in debating me.
You jumped into a conversation about the Catholic Church. You made comments about the Catholic Church. I've tackled you on those comments. You can say whatever comments you like about me. I'm not interested.
Yeah, it's fine. This is
not
called,
interested.
This is called ignorance, isn't it? I've made a mistake, and I don't give a shit. Actually,
I don't think I've. I mean, even if I have made a mistake, I'll go back and watch the video. I'll correct myself. But the tropes that I've heard in this discussion. That is common amongst the sort of liberal critics of the Christian faith. Those kind of tropes. They're just based on ignorance. We'll just move the camera, JC. We'll just move the camera.
All right. So what's happening, Johnny? Are you gonna start dancing around?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, you know, your camera is shy, or what's going on, bro?
Yeah. So the thing is that these kind of we're gonna wrap up because you've made the debate about me. I'm not interested in debating myself. The kind of tropes that we've heard are tropes amongst the so-called intelligentsia of England. These kind of bombastic, self-righteous, virtue-signalling hypocrites of Western liberal progressive thought. The idea that the Catholic Church has money that it should give to the poor. The idea that it doesn't help the poor. The idea that it's rife with paedophilia. That the priesthoods and these things, let's be clear, we've heard them mentioned by celebrities. They're produced and populated by celebrities. Stephen Fry in a public debate, Christopher Hitchens, two people I suspect are possibly people that John looks up to.
Possibly.
Correct me if I'm wrong. Correct me if I'm wrong. Do you like Christopher Hitchens? Do you like Christopher Hitchens? I'm asking you.
I'm not going to engage.
Do you like Christopher Hitchens? I'm asking you.
Do you like Christopher Hitchens?
Are you shy? Do you like Christopher Hitchens? Do you like Christopher Hitchens? No.
Are you not respecting my shyness?
No, I'm not respecting your shyness. Speaker's Corner is not a place for shy people. Speaker's Corner is not. If you're shy, why are you here? If you're shy, why are you here?
Why are you asking
So notice that when I said that I suspect John looks up to people like Christopher Hitchens and Stephen Fry, he was very shy. I suspect that silence is admission in this case. Stephen Fry and Christopher Hitchens populated anti-Catholic tropes, populated Christophobic stereotypes. And yet they are celebrated by our liberal progressive elites, like John. So at the end of the day, even though, ladies and gentlemen, if you did the same to the Islamic community, you would be accused of Islamophobia. So I'm calling out the hypocrisy of all you liberal elites. Yes.
Brilliant. Brilliant.